it's a great joy to share with you some thoughts about the Thessalonian saints of the Proto-Christian period and some troparia in their honor. Thessaloniki has been called Agiotokos Polis, a city giving birth to saints. In fact, there are more than 160 saints included in the Agiologion of Thessaloniki, this beautiful book in two volumes. There we can find their names and the mention of many others which are anonymous. We are going to briefly speak about some of the oldest Thessalonian saints from the beginning of the 4th century. Rejoice in the Lord, O city of Thessaloniki, is the incipit of a famous dikeron in honor of the city's patron, Saint Demetrius the Myroblite. Here you can see this dikeron in fully developed Middle Byzantine notation according to the Sticherarion 412 from the Holy Monastery Kutlumusiu on Mount Athos, dating from the middle of the 14th century according to the catalogue of Gregorios Stathis. Let's hear the beginning of the piece in its metrophonic structure, that is, with its main notes and its basic rhythm. The reconstruction of the basic rhythm is due to research conducted by Ewald Jammers, Jan van Biesen, Marina and Irina Skolnik, Simon Karas and Ioannis Arvanitis. It is in the first authentic mode. What we can read in the old manuscript. In order to get to the full melody, as written down by Hurmuzius the Archivarian in the first half of the 19th century, we have to consult the manuscript from the Metochion of the Holy Sepulchre with the number 707. According to this manuscript, and you can see a copy on the right side of the slide, we have the following melody. Very slow pace with a wonderful melismatic melody. Here in this slide you can see a musicological approach which compares the two sources we saw before along with a generative analysis to the slow melody. So we have on the first line the Kutlumusian manuscript, and then we have a transnotation in the first staff, followed by a rhythmical interpretation in the second one, according to the research conducted by Ioannis Arvanitis. And then in the third row, we have the Hurmuzian exegesis, along with a schematic transcription into staff. And on the bottom, we have a generative analysis for the slow melody. So rejoice in the Lord, O city of Thessaloniki, is what we will hear on Vespers of St. Demetrios on the 25th of October in the evening in the Basilica where his holy relics are kept, and of course we will hear this troparion all over the Orthodox world. Here you can see a beautiful mosaic of the 7th century with one of the oldest icons of Saint Demetrios, here represented between the Eparch and the Bishop. The mosaic dates to the 7th century. Saint Demetrios, the son of a wealthy family of Thessalonica, lived during the reign of the Roman emperors Diocletian and Maximian. Here you can see some pictures with a digital reconstruction of the city by the time of their successor Galerius, from 305 and onwards. From the time of Galerius, we have also the famous arch, the so-called Kamara, in the center of Thessaloniki. It's on the Via Egnatia, this ancient road which unified Rome with Constantinople. So if you have visited Thessaloniki, you surely remember Kamara. Saint Demetrios became a prominent warrior and Duke of Thessaly, thus being a major exponent of the Roman army. However, he understood that the main field of the great battle is the mind and the heart of human being itself, and therefore he was active as a teacher, speaking the truth of our Lord Jesus Christ to young people of his time. And he died as a martyr in the last year of the reign of Diocletian and Maximian in 305. Roman soldiers threw their spears in his coast, as you can see in this contemporary icon. Here you can see an impressive procession with the relics of the saint and his icon on the very same Via Egnatia we saw before. The photograph stems from the end of the 20th century. Saint Demetrios is a warm helper in most difficult situations of life. He is a great wonder worker. And here you can see a book which has been published during the last years. It contains many testimonies of people which have been healed or have been really helped in very difficult situations of their life. On the photo of the cover, you can see a fragment of his relics and the glass which is in his shrine, which is full of myron. As you can see, it runs on the glass inside the shrine which contains his relics. During Byzantine times, Saint Demetrios was bestowed with the so-called Great Week of Veneration, emulating the Great Week of Passions of our Lord Jesus Christ before Easter. The texts have been edited by the famous liturgist Ioannis Fundulis. The hymnographic texts are authored by the Thessalonian Saints hymnographers Eustathios and Simeon, and by different other poets. Also, towards the end of the last century, Elder Gerasimos Mikragiannanitis, here you can see him in the center of the photograph in the first row, enriched the hymnography in honor of Saint Demetrios with wonderful new texts. Father Gerasimos was the hymnographer of the Great Church. He had this title, so he wrote many, many poems to older and newer saints, and he is considered to have been the most important hymnographer after the fall of Constantinople. Let's now have a look at one of the beautiful compositions from the Holy Week of Saint Demetrios, which is a prosomion that is a contrafactum of the Hypermacho Stratego, Zbranoi Voevode, and makes a keen parallel between the Holy Mother of God as the protectress of Constantinople, the capital of the Eastern Roman Empire, and St. Demetrios as the protector of Thessaloniki, which was the co-capital of Byzantium. So let's try to sing it. It's in the plagal of the fourth mode. So you are most welcome to sing together with me. Let's see now how this melody applies also to the text for Saint Demetrios, which has been written by Ioannis Stavrakios, a hymnographer of the 13th century. So instead of saying ti hypermacho, we will say to hypermacho.
To hypermacho στρατηγό και αντιληπτόρη ευχαριστή. Με ελεύθερο
1 year earlier, in 304, the holy sisters Agape, Irene, and Hionia were burned for their faith, according to the martyrologion of the 4th century, where the acts of their process have been preserved. The keen answer of Hionia at the order of the authority to eat from the offerings to the idols was the following: I believe in the living God, and I don't do this. Let's now listen to the beginning of the supplicatory canon, the Parakletikos Canon, written by the elder Hierasimos Mikragiannanitis we saw before, in honor of the three holy martyrs. The melody is written down these days according to the oral tradition of the congregation in the unique church of the Holy Three Martyrs in Thessaloniki. So please join if you want. It's in the plagal of the fourth mode, in the triphonic structure.
Άγιε του Θεού πρεσβεύσατε υπέρ ημών, τριάς αθλοφόρων πανευκλέων, τριάδα την θείαν δυσοποίησατε εκτενούς, όσαν λυτρωθήμεν κινδύνων και πολυπλοκών σκανδάλων του ο Θεός.
Contemporary to Saints Demetrios and his companions Nestor and Lupos, contemporary to Agape, Irene and Hionia we just spoke before, is also Saint Anicia, a beautiful virgin from a rich family of Thessalonica, which remained orphan in an early age and disposed all her heritage to the church, taking care of poor and sick people in the city, and also of persecuted Christians. She was put to death by a Roman soldier when going to a secret church service. By the end of the last century, her relics were found in an excavation together with the fundaments of a Paleo-Christian basilica outside the eastern walls of Thessaloniki. You can see the photo on the right side of this slide. It's below the boulevard of the 3rd September today. And the foundings, many of them, are kept today in the Byzantine Museum of Thessaloniki. The relics of Saint Anicia are kept today in the Basilica of Saint Demetrios, and you can see them here on her feast day on the 30th of December in the middle of the church. Let's sing her apolitikion. The neumes have been written with a vertical axis also in order to show in a more easy way and for beginners how the voice has to go up and down or repeat the previous note. It is in the first authentic mode, in the so-called Dorian mode, and it's a prosomion to an aftomelon called Tiserimu Politis.
Ananes.
This ananes is the intonation formula, and then we start.
Ασκήσε ως αγώση και αθλήσε ως εμάση, σεμνίωση ο μάρτης, ανησία πανεφήμε, ως θύμα προσυνέχθης το Χριστό, και δόξης ηξιώθης ουρανών. Δια τούτος εν άσμας ιερείς τιμούμεν ανακράζοντες δόξα το δεδοκό της ισχύ δόξα το σε Στεφανός αντί δόξα το ενεργούντι διά σου πασινιάματα.
So this was one of her apolitikia. If you want to listen more to the Paraklesis of Saint Anicia, sung by our female choir, named in her honor, you can follow the link which you see in this slide. Before finishing, we are going to listen to the end of her paraklesis. And by now, thank you so much for your attention. Thank you for the beautiful invitation. And may all of us, all the entire world, have the prayers of these great saints of Thessalonica. Thank you so much.
Ευχών των Αγίων Πατέρων ημών, Κύριε Ιησού Χριστέ ο Θεός, ελέησον ημάς.